Where's the wood coming from? Is that a north?
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Wait, Becky, where are you going? Come on, don't be like that. Are you fucking reading right now? How are you so boring?
Oh, I'm boring? Could you be any more cliche?
I don't know. I don't technically remember what that word
means. Well, it means you think these are going to be the best years of your life, so you're going to destroy your body with drugs and alcohol, and then one day, when you realize time is real, you're going to regret every decision you've ever made and sink into an unfathomable depression that will swallow you whole.
Want to make out?
Ew.
Let me rephrase that. Want to make out? Come on, Bex. When's the last time you cut loose?
Fine. I will make out with you for 20 minutes, but that's it. All my clothes stay on.
Undershirt over bra?
Okay.
Hell yeah, brother! Go back to your cabin! Whoop. Whoa.
Doing here?
It's my night.
What are you talking about?
Thursday, it's the full moon. It's my night.
Tonight is the crow Sabbath.
Dude, that's like 3 weeks away.
Bullshit.
No, no. Come down here, I'll show you.
I'm right here.
Okay, show me. Got it right here.
Check your sketch?
Can you not say sketch? You sound like a dipshit.
Okay, well, someone's obviously in one of their moods tonight.
Whatever, I'm going back to the cornfield. Have fun.
Hey, are you okay?
I'm fine.
Oh, this doesn't look like fine.
Well, I am.
Whoa,
I'm fine.
Okay, let's reel it in, brother. Okay, you've been acting weird for weeks now, and now this? Mr. Structure, Mr. Crow Sabbath? I mean, this is not like you.
Yeah, well, maybe I'm not like me right now. Maybe I'm...
It doesn't matter. I'll see you tomorrow. You can tell me how it went.
Bro, what's going on?
Nothing!
Gregory Glattman, I'm your best friend, and I know when something's going on.
I don't know. I just don't know if I'm super into this anymore.
This what?
This lifestyle.
What are you talking about?
I don't know if this is what I want to do with my, like, one wild and precious life anymore.
What
you
does
know?
That even mean?
That's what I'm trying to figure out, Kevin.
We've been doing this for over 50 years.
I know that. And it's not like I have any regrets about it. These have been some of the best 50 years of my life.
This is your life! Camp Creek River! You remember the summer of 83, you sacrificed 16 souls to the Crow God that night.
Of course I remember that. It's an incredibly special memory for me. But maybe I want to start trying to create new kinds of memories.
Well, why the heck would you want to go and do something like that? This isn't just a work thing, is it?
You're going to give me the business.
I'm not going to give you the business.
Promise.
I promise.
Pinky promise. Stamp it.
Gosh.
I met someone.
Oh, Greg.
You said you wouldn't give me the business.
I'm not get... What's her name?
Pauline.
How don't you two even meet?
On the internet.
She's incredible, Kevin. She's smart. She's funny. She, like, gets me on, like, a cellular level. She reminds me of...
She reminds me of Tabitha.
Oh, there it is, Gregory! Tabitha and her friends left you for dead in the cornfield after she pretended to, like,
you ever heard of peer pressure, idiot? We had a real connection.
You shucked her skin off, Greg!
Whatever, Pauline's different.
Oh, they're always different.
What is that supposed to mean?
Mm-hmm.
Pauline's not like the others. A, I've never met someone online before. B, we chat for hours about things that you couldn't even understand, like poems.
Oh, wow, so you're gonna meet her in real life.
That's on the future to happen.
You know you're gonna have to shuck her skin off and stuff her full of hay.
Well, maybe knowing her in this capacity first will humanize her enough so they don't have to shuck and stuff her.
You can't change your nature, dude.
Nature is changed, dude.
Oh, so you're gonna take her to the soda fountain? One malt, two straws? You're gonna give her your promise ring? Hey, look, man. When the swamp hag cursed me for stealing her daughter's virginity, she gave me a destiny. Just like the crow god did for you. That is not your life. This is...
But is this a life? I mean, what do we do? 4 months out of the year, we chase a bunch of horny teenagers and wear their faces, or suck their brains out of their eye sockets, or make big tree structures out of their arms and legs, or feed them to each other, or sew the still alive ones to the dead ones and leave them in the cornfield for the crows, or just cut them in half with a sort of top-down situation, or we take their hearts out, or we beat them to death with each other's spines, or tie them up in a big naked ball and roll them down the mountain. And beyond that, what? What do we do for the rest of the year? Huh? I sit in my cornfield alone. And you sit in your swamp alone. Is that it? What is our purpose?
Oh, hey. Buddy, come on. Think about the best times you've had in your life. What are you doing in them?
Murdering?
Yeah. So do you think Pauline is going to be cool with you just going out and murdering?
Maybe.
Oh, get real, Hoss. I have to imagine she's like a normal person, which you most definitely are not. You are a pagan, ritualistic serial killer. It's never gonna work out.
If you ask me, it sounds like you're kind of shaming him. You can drop the act. I know what's going on.
You know nothing, mortal child.
I know you don't really talk like that. Are you making...
What? No, you're doing that.
Oh, Cecil Pete, how much did you hear?
Since the thing about offering souls to the crow god?
Oh, son of a biscuit, fuck my ass.
Actually, Greg? Gregory?
Greg is cool.
Greg, I think Pauline sounds great. And you bring up some really salient points. It sounds like you might have some unresolved attachment stuff.
How did you know that?
I'm a psych major. There's obviously a lot of love here, but Kevin, hi Kevin, I'm Becky. Kevin, what I'm getting from you is an unwillingness to accept the fact that your friend might be evolving in a way that makes you feel threatened.
Okay, this is boring. I'm getting bored now.
Is that gonna make things go back to the way they were?
It's gonna make me feel awesome.
Okay, has it ever made you feel awesome? Has it ever filled the void?
I don't have a void.
Oh my God, you have the hugest void.
Okay, hold on, Greg. Let's give him some space to process. Kevin, would you be willing to pause and consider the possibility that Greg meeting someone might arouse feelings of jealousy or envy or even fear at confronting your own loneliness?
Well, I'm not afraid of anything, okay? I'm literally the butcher of Black Mountain.
When was the last time you came down from the mountain?
Well, I can't because the swamp hag won't let me, so.
Well, I'm not talking about your physical body geographically. I mean your emotional body or the pain body, in a Tolian sense.
Pain body?
When was the last time you entered into the world, sought a real connection?
Never.
Oh, kick rocks, Greg.
What? The only reason that
hey,
you
said... I feel...
I feel that the only reason you're not afraid of anything is because you've structured your life so as to completely avoid the unknown.
Wow. Kevin?
I could eat your whole head.
Right, but can you eat, as it were, the truth of what your friend is saying? Can you digest it? Can you really take it in?
Why don't I take in your stupid face in my buttonhole?
Okay, you're deflecting. Kevin. Kevin, look at me. You've reached a crossroads in this relationship. You can either sit down stubbornly in the middle of the road, head back the way you came, alone, or head toward a possibly dazzling new horizon with your beloved friend.
I'm ugly! Oh, God!
What do I see?
Hey,
I'm ugly too.
No.
That doesn't have to mean that we can't live beautifully. Maybe there's another, gentler road to travel. Maybe we can...
Bex, you okay?
Are you fucking kidding me? That was like the most beautiful moment I've ever seen.
No, wait, they were gonna kill you.
No, they were not. They were changing. It was happening. They were shattering a paradigm.
Holy fuck. I've never shot a gun before. The barrel is so hot. I'm so turned on right now. Let's fuck.
Get away from me.
Come on, I'm a hero now. Let's fuck. Come on.
You are not a hero. You are nothing. Nothing. You're just a second string lacrosse player who's probably gonna date rape some college girl and then get acquitted and then become a politician. You piece of fuck! You camp counselor! I am doing the world a favor! I am doing the world a favor! I am doing the world a favor!
Man, it's like 1983 all over again!
Oh, dear. Becky? Are you okay?
I liked it.
What?
Fuck, I like it. I loved it. I feel like an archangel. Do I have wings? Do I have huge burning wings?
Heck yeah, you do!
Tio.
Is this how you guys feel all the time?
Pretty much.
I'm in.
Becky, why don't we wait a minute and...
So what can you... it, pussy? You guys want to get the rest of the counselors?
You bet your bottom!
Wow! It's fuck time, my babies!
I love this chick!
What'd you call me?
I love the strong and autonomous woman with agency.
That's right. And don't you forget it, or I'll make you my dirty little dog-ass prison dog dog-yard bitch! Now let's roll.
Yes, ma'am! Hey, guys, wait up!